A breaking news story we are following tonight. Senior administration officials telling CNN the U.S. is now providing manned aerial surveillance planes over Nigeria in order to try to find the more than 200 girls kidnapped by terrorists there. The United States is also sharing satellite images with the Nigerian government, but the question remains whether the United States should support negotiating with terrorists. Negotiating with terrorists is something America has, in practice, vowed to never do, but it may happen. A Nigerian official says it's a real possibility. And the leader of Boko Haram, he's the one setting the terms.
Wallah, billahi alladhi la ilaha illahu, ha'ula ilbanat, la takhruj min yadina illa ba'dama taraktum ikhwanana fi sijnikum.
On that same video released today by the French news agency Agence France-Presse, these images, reportedly the kidnapped girls chanting, "Praise be to Allah," their heads covered. If what you're looking at is authentic, it is the first time we have seen any of the girls since they were taken 29 days ago. This video, with all of those girls covered, sitting so far from home, chanting the Quran. U.S. officials are now closely examining the video for clues, and they say they have no reason to believe the tape is not authentic, although they are not sure when it was made. Congressman Peter King, who called for Boko Haram to be designated a terrorist group 3 years ago, will join me along with the first man to attack terrorist financing for the United States, Juan Zarate, in just a moment. But first, Nema Albiger. She made the daunting trip to the girls' village, and she spoke with one of them who escaped.
In here, in these rooms, is where the girls were sleeping when armed men in what they describe as military uniforms came to their dormitory gate and told them that they'd come to protect them. The girls started to assemble in the yard as ordered to. They didn't realize who the men really were until it was too late.
They said, okay, we enter this lorry.
This girl managed to escape. She's now too fearful to show her face, too fearful to go back.
A big lorry.
Big lorry?
Yes.
They came with a big lorry?
Yes.
Was it one or more?
Seven
lorries?
Yes.
Trucks, motorbikes. Residents here tell us this raid was effectively a shopping trip for Boko Haram. Over 200 girls dragged from their beds to be sold off as bounty. A message that the militant group's edicts on female education must be heeded. But a way also for big men with guns to make money off terrified girls.
If indeed you work, I will never go again.
You'll never go back to school?
Yes.
Because they made you afraid?
Yes.
Before the militants left, they destroyed everything they could. Textbooks, the library, the laboratory, their attempt to forever shutter this school. Elizabeth and Mary are friends, members of the same church. Their daughters were also friends, hoping one day to study medicine. They and many of their classmates never made it home from school.
We are pleasing them to leave our doctors.
They say they still feel powerless, no closer to finding their daughters nearly a month after they were taken.
Nema, those pictures of the school and the beds with the metal and the mattresses burned out. I mean, it's frightening and powerful. And I know that it was dangerous what you did, the assignment. You had a very tough time getting to Chibok from the capital and where you are tonight. It would normally take about a day, but I know it took you and your crew nearly 4 days to get there.
Well, I think it just really gives you a sense of how impenetrable that terrain is, Aaron. It was a tough trip, but I think what made it tougher is that when you got out into those wide open spaces, you really were on your own. This Nigerian force reinforcement and build-up that the government keeps speaking about, that's meant to be hunting for the girls, they were pretty light on the ground in the areas we were in, and there were constant reports and rumors about movement, still movement, by Boko Haram in those villages surrounding Chibok, pretty much with impunity, Aaron.
All right, Nema, thank you very much, and really amazing reporting. Thank you so much for doing that. And